A few too many drinks on a night out, and you'll most likely wake up with a pretty unenjoyable hangover. It's often thought that dehydration causes hangovers, but there's a little bit more going on. So how does our body break down alcohol, and what causes hangovers? As soon as you swallow your first drink, a small amount is absorbed into your blood vessels and your tongue and mouth, with the rest of the alcohol rapidly absorbed into your bloodstream through your stomach and small intestine. Within 30 to 90 minutes, the alcohol levels in your blood begin to peak after a single drink, being spread to all the organs around your body through your bloodstream. Between 90 to 98% of alcohol gets broken down by your liver, with the rest being removed through your urine, sweat, or through your lungs, which is what allows alcohol breath tests. But your brain, stomach, and pancreas also metabolize alcohol. Two enzymes primarily found in your liver are mostly responsible for helping break down alcohol. ADH metabolizes the ethanol in your drink to acetaldehyde, an extremely toxic substance and a group 1 human carcinogen, with it being damaging to DNA and causing abnormal muscle development. As it's toxic, your body reacts to it, with it being responsible for an increased heart rate, headache, and nausea, with its poisonous effects on your body being what contributes to a hangover. Your body quite quickly wants to get rid of this toxic substance, so ALDH enzymes in your liver break down the acetaldehyde into acetic acid, which is then broken down into carbon dioxide and water. If you drink a small amount of alcohol at a time, your body can do this process quick enough that not too much damage to your body occurs, but drinking large amounts can cause a buildup of acetaldehyde, as your body cannot break it down quick enough. Between us, our bodies have varying levels of ADH enzymes, and your ethnicity can also affect this process. Those from Southeast Asia, for example, are known for flushing when they drink alcohol, and feel very sick with small amounts of alcohol, due to their body struggling to break down the acetaldehyde quick enough, thanks to them having very low of ADH enzymes, which are able to get rid of it. A European and Japanese person with a blood alcohol count of 0.5% could see the European have acetaldehyde levels 17 times less than a Japanese person, for example. While acetaldehyde toxicity is thought to be a major contributor to hangovers, as mentioned earlier, dehydration is also a contributor to hangovers. By drinking 3 shots, which have 50 grams of ethanol and 120 mils of liquid, you'll urinate between 600 to 1,000 milliliters of water in the following hours due to this, which means unless you're drinking a fair whack of water, you'll end up pretty dehydrated. Chemical byproducts such as methanol from the fermentation process are also contributors, with bourbon, whiskey, and red wine having higher concentrations. In fact, one study found that in order, brandy produced the worst hangover, followed by red wine, rum, whiskey, white wine, and gin, with vodka and pure alcohol causing the least severe hangovers. So next time you take a drink, you'll hopefully know what your body is up to and how it's breaking the alcohol. Thanks for watching.